Hello friends, continuing our contribution at your fingertips series, this is the fourth video of our series. If you have not watched our previous three videos, do watch our previous three videos. In this video, we are going to talk about Council of India Act 1861 as well as Council of India Act 1892. Let's first discuss Indian Council Act 1861. It was first, you can say the landmark in India's constitutional and political history. Features, what were the features of Indian Council Act? First feature was it started representative institution by including nominated member in law making process. It was the first which started representative institution by including non-official members in law making process by the by British but nominated Indian members. Who were they? The Viceroy, we know, Viceroy, the nominated, we can say is representative, the RMD, you remember it as RMD, Regional Managing Director. You can say R stands for Raja of Banaras, M stands for Raja of Patiala, and D for Dinakar Rao. Okay, so it is obvious that British nominated their own members who are simply a rubber stamp to the legislation they were intent to pass. So these are called as the nominated members. And what happened in the nominated members? The nominated members, after the completion of it, the process of decentralization started. You remember the process of centralization started from Regulating Act 1773 and continued up to 1833, the Charter Act, which was the most centralized act. And the process of decentralization started from 1861 and continued up to 1937 with the provincial autonomy given in the act. You can say the 1861, the legislation was becoming decentralized. Okay, the province of Bombay and province of Madras got the legislative powers again through the Indian Council Act 1861. And then after, what happened? It reversed, as I said, it reversed the slowly the centralization, and it reached its full autonomy in 1937. Provincial autonomy, which we will study later on. Then after, the legislation on the devolution resulted in completion. Then after the legislative, there were three legislative councils were formed. What were it? You remember it as B, N, and P. B stands for Bengal, Bengal in 1862. M N stands for North West Frontier Province. Northwest Frontier Province in 1866. Then P stands for Punjab. Punjab in 1867. So you remember as B and P, Bengal in 1862, Northwest Frontier Province in 1866, and Punjab in 1867. Then after what happened? The portfolio system was started by Lord Canning. Lord Canning in 1859, as we all know. Then what happened in the portfolio system? What happened in the Viceroy? Roy's in council. A member was given charge of one or more departments to issue orders in behalf of the department. Viceroy got ordinance making power without concurrence of Legislative Council. Life of ordinance 6 weeks. So let's have a quick recap of Indian Council Act. It was the first way of representative institution by including Indians as a nominated members to the Governor General in Council, who were the first person to be recommended. You can say, remember it as RDM, RMD, or Raja Banaras, Maharaja Patiala, and Dinakar Rao. And the legislative process, which was being centralized, started becoming decentralized starting from 1861 Indian Council Act. And it gave separate powers to Bombay and Madras presidencies. Then after what happened, the autonomous process continued till 1937, where the provincial autonomy was given. Then three legislative councils were formed. First one was the Bengal BBM, BNP. You remember it as BNP, B for Bengal in 1862. Then Northwest Frontier Province in 1866 and Punjab in 1867. Then coming to the portfolio system was started by Lord Canning, as we all know. The Viceroy's, there was a member in the Viceroy's in Council who was made in charge of a specific department, which made the orders on behalf of the department where he or she is in charge. Then last is the Viceroy was given the ordinance making power without the concurrence of Legislative Council. And the life of the legislative, you can say the ordinance, is 6 weeks. Then after completion of this, now we will move to Indian Council Act 1892. We all know that Indian Council Act 1892 is increased the nominated members but retained official majority you can say that they have increased the members, non-official members. You can say that this is non-official members, non-official Indian members, but retain the official majority, so that their decision making process shouldn't be influenced by the Indians in the same council. Then after what happened, the legislative council was divided and gave power, certain powers. What is the power? Power number one was discussing the budget. Previously there was no power for the Indians to discuss any budget. And later, second is addressing the question. Addressing questions to the executive. Addressing question to the executive. This was not previously there, and it was started later on. Then the nomination of members. How were the members were nominated? We have to know the nominated. How they were, as we all know, that one is Central Legislative Council. Legislative Council by Viceroy. But who were the members of this Central Legislative Council? They were nominated by provincial provincial councils. Provincial legislative council and Bengal Chamber of Commerce. Then second one is provincial legislative council by state governors. They were recommended by, you remember as DMUCTJ. If you will remember, you can easily expand it. D for district boards, M for municipalities, U for universities, C for chambers, T for trade unions, and Z for jamindars. Note, there is a important thing which happened in Indian Council Act 1892. What is it? First time there was provision of election to both central and provincial council, but the word election was not used. It said nomination by certain bodies. It was for the first time the election held both in central and provincial legislative council, but the word election was not used. it said that nomination by certain body. Then let's have a quick recap of, we can say 1861, it was the first landmark of constitutional and political history of India. The first is Indian, the beginning of the representative institution by Indians, and the RMD were nominated Raja Banaras, Maharaja Patiala, and the last is Dinakar Rao. Then after, what happened is the centralization process, it was started during 1833, was reached at 1833, and it was decentralization. Madras and Bombay were given certain legislative autonomy. Then later on, what happened in the three legislative councils were formed. One is Bengal in 1862, then Northwest Frontier Province in 1866, and Punjab in 1867. Portfolio system was started during the time of Lord Canning in 1869. In that system, what happened? A member of the Viceroy's Council was in charge of a specific one department or more department to issue orders on behalf of the department. Then last is the governor was given the charge of ordinance making, and this ordinance making was valid without the concurrence of legislative assembly, which was valid for 6 weeks. Then coming to 1892 is what happened. The nomination members were the number which was very limited in 1861, which was increased in 1892, but official majority was retained in the council. Then what happened, what changes it brought in legislation? First, there was previously there was no provision of discussing the budget. In 1892, there was discussing the budget was given the power to the Indian, then addressing the question to the executive. Previously, the addressing question was not there for the Indians. Then later on, the nomination took place. The Central Legislative Council, headed by the Viceroy, provincial the members were nominated by the Provincial Council and Bengal Chamber of Commerce, and by the Provincial Legislative Council, by the state provincial governor. They were DMU, CTZ, you remember it is District Board, municipalities, universities, then C stands for chambers, then trade and jamidars were the members. Then first time, note, it is very important that in this particular 1892, there was some sort of a election, but the word election was not used in it, and it said what, the nominated by certain bodies. If you like the video, just do like the video. Since we are teaching it free of cost, try to share maximum with your friends who are preparing for UPSC, SSC, State Public Service Commission, Banking, Railway, wherever constitution question comes. And thank you very much.